Rory joins now. First of all, explain yourself, Mr. Reid. We were expecting you before 8 o'clock, 10 to 8 at least. Have you gone all Hollywood already?
I apologise. I apologise. Listen, my life recently has been 3 a.m. or 4 a.m. starts.
We know how that feels.
And it's all caught up on me. I was just around the corner, but you know when you plug your phone in, you rely on that to wake you up? Yeah. The cable on my phone died. I'm not all Hollywood. I'm down to earth.
I don't know. I think the last person that blew us out was Mariah Carey. Then we've got Rory.
Yes.
You know, you're up
yes.
there.
Am I on that level?
You're on that level.
Yes. I love it. You don't have quite
You've
as many
kittens.
So.
No, not quite. It's great to see you. Thank you for coming in.
Thank you.
I'd imagine that the sort of the anticipation, because you guys have been filming this for a long time now, but the anticipation and the build-up for Sunday night must be something else for you.
It's great. It's almost like a lifelong build-up for me personally. But, yeah, I imagine the people watching the Top Gear audience are hugely excited about what's about to happen, and rightly so, because we've got an incredible series lined up.
It must be a dream extension, though, isn't it?
In some ways, yeah. I mean, you know, if think about it like this. It's almost like winning X Factor, basically. If you're a singer and you've been singing all your career and suddenly you make it to the big time, it's on that kind of parallel. But for me, you know, I'm very serious about what I do, by the way. This is not just entertainment for me. This is a big deal. I'm looking forward to actually taking people, through the process of what happens and showing off each car that I drive and making sure that they enjoy each moment.
But of course, as you're a big fan of Top Gear anyway, you're going to be putting yourself under an awful lot of pressure to measure up to the standards that were left by Jeremy Clarkson, Richard, and of course James May.
Not really.
But you know that everybody waiting, going, is it going to be as good? Is it going to be different? How are we going to measure up? And undoubtedly, I'm sure that you look at it with those eyes as well as a fan of the show.
There is no pressure on my part, really, because I'm a fan of Top Gear, definitely, and I know what came before, but the process that I've been through recently has shown me that it will live up. It will be different, but it will live up to the expectations of the fans. And we've worked so hard in trying to maintain the essence of Top Gear and trying to maintain that fun and that connection with people. And we're pretty confident that what we deliver will be this hugely enjoyable, hugely inclusive new series that I'm not really nervous at all. Especially the videos that I've made, I think they're incredible.
So you'll be fine.
Yeah, no, absolutely.
And we're just looking at a shot of the new team as they're lining up there. And undoubtedly, with something as big as this, 350 million people around the world watch it, there's been lots of stories about fallouts between the presenters, particularly Chris is under a lot of pressure leading this story. From your perspective, have you noticed any of that? Has there been any problems?
No, it's 99.9% nonsense, to be honest with you. There's been a lot of tabloid speculation, but the truth is, when we all connect on the set, there's no problem whatsoever. And you know, I don't expect people to believe that, but the truth is, I turn up, Chris gives me a hug, Matt gives me a hug, Eddie gives me a hug, Sabine gives me a hug, Chris Harris gives me a massive hug.
Do Matt and Chris give each other hugs? Because
they do, I was watching it too, because I read the papers, right? So I turn up on set and I watch those guys. And the first thing I see is them giving each other a massive high five, a big embrace. And it fills me with this kind of, like, this feeling that, okay, we're going to be okay. Like, don't believe what you read in the papers. And these guys get on because they have this connection of cars, and that's the most important thing.
Come Sunday, where will you be? Will you be watching with the family, or will you be sitting quietly?
Hey, I'll be with the family. I'll be about 2 feet from the sofa with some champagne or something, just soaking it up like everyone else.
Will you be on Twitter as well? Will you be looking, watching the reaction?
I'll be on Twitter. If you want to reach out to me, let me know. Yeah, I'll
there
be
you
there,
go.
Definitely.
At Mr. Rory Reid. Lovely to meet you, Rory. Best of luck on Sunday.
Thank you.
We'll be gripped. Our family absolutely adore the programme. We can't wait to see what you've all done with it.
Yeah, they'll be excited. Thank you.
Good stuff.